Ladies and gentlemen, as a director of normal language, let's go straight to business. Again.
Sabai.
Sabai.
Today, we are here to show the talents of not only inmates, but of volunteers that we have. Since 2015, when we started officially to volunteer to inspire someone in the prison, we have discovered talents, we have discovered intellectuals, we have discovered people who are different, but they find themselves in the prisons. So today, we are here to join hands with these people to showcase their talents.
In other sense, when I'm a prisoner, my mom would never tell me, say, innocent, go to school, go to school. And you go to school, every day the time you go to school, education is the key, so I left school for no education.
Today is a very important day because so many things that they will get for learn, where these important people, they don't bring up for telling them.
Hello to the women. Hello to the young guys. Okay, I'm called Kelly Dipoko. Today, I'm going to talk on the topic how to live a healthy lifestyle in a prison environment. Health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social welfare. Everything about disease prevention boils down to hygiene.
That in here we find it very difficult getting sharp objects, especially those we use in shaving, like say blades for example. How then do you think this situation as well could be remedied?
If you have fire, take from your friend, expose it to heat for a period of time, like 5 minutes, and then you keep it and then you use it. You sterilize it.
This was quarter whole day. Now quarter way, great men they don't come out from this quarter. I mean this particular quarter whole day inside so. Bear Joseph and Twa when a big man today will know he come out from this quarter. Nelson Mandela, the great president of South Africa, will start today for all sides of the world. It don't stay with the same quarter, but for a different place. This quarter within only 3 things will make you change. Your mind, your body, and your soul.
We'll talk about the mind. It's your mind that is propelling you, not your body. So if you are in prison, you can let your mind drift away, and you can find yourself in the city of New York.
My brothers and sisters here. I've seen those that are making gato. I've seen those that are making chin-chin. I've seen those that are making bags. I'm encouraging them that you should not hide those skills. Teach one another. Teach one another. I can't lose this nothing while lighting another one.
We are taking down the recipe of preparing a wonderful traditional meal here titled Ekwang. So our first step.
I want to salute the British High Commission Yaounde and the Noela Lyonga Foundation for such an initiative.
I'm always looking at it, I take a ring out of the bed of life.